Hare Krishna, let's learn of Navadvipa Dhamma, which is in West Bengal, India, and also about the birthplace of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu called as Antardvipa. What is Navadvipa? Nava means nine and Dvipa means islands. How did Navadvipa came into existence? Let's see. It is said in Ananta Samhita that once Krishna enjoys with one of the gopis called Virija. On hearing this, Radharani thought to attract Krishna away from Virija by creating beautiful place between Ganges and Yamuna rivers. With help of her sakis, she creates this magnificent place with creepers, bumblebees, deers, filled with jasmine, mallika, malati flowers and tulsi forests. Radha dressed beautifully, played a beautiful melody on the flute and attracted Krishna. Krishna comes here, and by understanding Radharani's mood, Krishna says that he will live here in this place eternally. So this place is called as New Vrindavan or Nava Vrindavan, and this place looks like an island. It is called as Navadvipa. If anyone worships here, attains devotional service quickly and obtains results of going to all sacred places. When anyone hears this glories of Navadvipa, all their sins will be removed and will bestow devotional service to them. Let us see what is Navadvipa, what are these nine islands and their connection with nine limbs of bhakti. Antardvipa represents Atmanivedanam, means complete surrender to Krishna. Simantadvipa represents Shravanam, means hearing the glories of Krishna. Godrumadvipa represents Kirtanam, means chanting the names of Krishna. Madhyadvipa represents Smaranam, means remembering Krishna. Koladvipa represents Padasevanam, means serving the lotus feet of Krishna. Ritudvipa represents Archanam, means deity worship to Krishna. Jahanadvipa represents Vandanam, means offering prayers to Krishna. Mudadramadvipa represents Dasyam, means being servant to Krishna. Rudradvipa represents Sakhyam, means being as a friend to Krishna. Let us see one of the important dvipas, Antardvipa, and how Antardvipa got its name. Actually, Antardvipa was previously known as Atopur. During Dwapar Yuga, Lord Krishna was displaying his pastimes in Vrindavana. Krishna and his friends were grazing calves in the forest. Brahma decides to test whether Krishna is God or not and steals the calves by his yogic power. Krishna knew this and teaches a lesson to Brahma by expanding himself as calves. Brahma realizes his offense and offers prayers to the Lord and begged for forgiveness. Krishna excused Brahma, but Brahma was not satisfied and feels he will commit an offense again when Krishna comes as Gauranga in his next pastime in Kali Yuga. So Brahma sees only Gauranga can help on this and therefore comes to Navadvipa and worships Gauranga. Lord Gauranga appears and tells Brahma that he will be born in low birth in Kali Yuga, but will be a great devotee known as Haridasa, and therefore he will not offend him again. Hearing this, Brahma asks Lord about the purpose for manifesting pastimes in Navadvipa. Lord answers Brahma from his heart, saying, "O Brahma, please listen, I will tell you something from the inner core of my heart, Antar, but do not describe this fact anywhere in scriptures. I will manifest myself accepting the mood of my devotee. I will manifest the most secret Sankirtana, giving Raja Prema. Everyone will be a follower of Raja Bhava in the mood of Madhurya Rasa." As Lord spoke from his heart, Antar, this place is called as Antardvipa. Now, let us see the Yoga Pita, the birthplace of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, which is at Antardvipa. Yoga means connection. Yoga Pita means Lord connects himself to this earth or descends to earth. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is none other than Krishna himself. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is also called as Nimai, as he is born under the neem tree which you are seeing. Next to the tree is a small hut with deities of Jagannath Mishra, father of Mahaprabhu, and Sachi Mata, mother of the Mahaprabhu. Sachi Mata is holding baby Nimai on her lap. There are also two Shivalingas at Yogapita, Gopeshwar Shiva, who admits one to Lord's service, and Kshetrapala Shiva, who is the protector of the Dhamma. Now, let us see other important places at Antardvipa. Let us go to Srivasangan, which is near to Yogapeta. Srivasangan is the house of Srivasa Thakura. You may ask, who is Srivasa Thakura? Srivasa Thakura is none other than Narada Muni. Srivasangan is called as the birthplace of Haranam Sankirtana because Chaitanya Mahaprabhu along with his associates performed Kirtan here. This place is also called as Kholbangaranga, the place where Mridanga was broken by Chand Kazi to stop Harinam Sankirtan. It is described that Chand Kazi is Kamsa. You can see the broken Mridanga in the picture. Now, let us go to Advaita Bhavan, which is also near to Yogapeta. Advaita Bhavan is the house of Advaita Acharya. Then, who is Advaita Acharya? Advaita Acharya is combined incarnation of Mahavishnu and Sadashiva. What did Advaita Acharya do? So, in Advaita Bhavan, Advaita Acharya prayed and cried with all his heart to the Lord and compelled him to appear as Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to save the people of Kali Yuga. Now, let us go to Gadadharangan. Gadadharangan is also near to Yogapeta. Gadadharangan is the house of Gadadhara Pandita. Who is Gadadhara Pandita now? Gadadhara Pandita has been described as Srimati Radharani. As Gadadhara Pandita was always absorbed in the thoughts of Krishna and always speaking Krishna Katha in the association of devotees. As young boys also, Lord Chaitanya and Gadadhara Pandita were inseparable, just like Krishna and Radharani are inseparable. In Gadadharangan, you are seeing the deities of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Gadadhara Pandita. Now, let us all go to Sri Chaitanya Math. Chaitanya Math is at Antardvipa. In Sri Chaitanya Math, there is Samadhi and Bhajan Kutir of Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakura, spiritual master of Srila Prabhupada. Srila Prabhupada is the founder acharya of ISKCON. You'll also find Sri Sri Radha Gandharvika Giridhari in Chaitanya Math. These deities were installed by Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakura. We also see Giri Govardhana, Radha Kunda, Shama Kunda in Chaitanya Math. Now, let's go to Murari Gupta's house. Murari Gupta's house is also at Antardvipa. Murari Gupta is none other than Hanuman. Murari Gupta is very intimate associate of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Murari Gupta was very dear to Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, just like Hanuman was dear to Lord Rama in Treta Yuga. We can see Lord Rama, Mother Sita, Lakshmana and Hanuman deities in Murari Gupta's house. Now, ISKCON Sri Mayapur Chandodaya Mandir, which is also situated in Antardvipa. We can see beautiful deities of Sri Sri Radha Madhava, Ashtasakhi, Panchatattva and Lord Narasimhadev. We also can see Srila Prabhupada's Pushpa Samadhi and Bhajan Kutir. 24 hours Kirtana takes place here following Srila Prabhupada's instruction that there be continuous chanting of the holy name in the Dhamma. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. And this is Gurukul and MIHET, Mayapur Institute of Higher Education and Training, where all bhakti courses take place for students. So today we saw one of the dvipas, Antardvipa. I hope you all enjoyed it. Hare Krishna.